Hello friends, welcome to Total Quality Management course. I am Professor Rushikesh Vikolle, working as an assistant professor in Department of Civil Engineering, Sanjeevani College of Engineering, Kopargaon. Welcome all of you to lecture number 1, that is Introduction to TQM. So, as per the SPPU Pune, the TQM and MIS has course code 401005 and the examination scheme for this subject is in semester exam for 30 marks having the duration 1 hour and end semester exam for 70 marks of the duration 2.5 hours. The course teaching scheme is 3 hours per week and this course has 3 credits. Next is course objective. There are 6 course objective this subject is having. First is to understand the quality in the construction. Second, to elaborate the concept of total quality management. Next, third one, to apply TQM tools and techniques in civil engineering. Fourth, to compare the construction activities with quality manual and ISO 9001 principles. Fifth one, to describe management control and certifications in TQM. And the last, to develop a MIS for construction organization. So these are the course objective. Next is course outcomes. So this subject is also having 6 course outcomes. First one is an ability to understand the concept of quality in day-to-day life and businesses. Second one, an ability to use total quality management principles in the construction. Third one, the students will able to apply TQM tools and the techniques in civil engineering. Fourth one, the students will able to compare the construction activities with quality manual and ISO 9001 principles. Fifth one, student be capable for management control and the certifications in TQM. And the last is an ability to develop a MIS for construction organization. So these 6 are course outcomes. Next is talking about the textbook. There are 4 textbook preferred by the SPPU Pune as per the syllabus is concerned, and out of which the total engineering quality management by Sunil Sharma, this is the best book. Next is reference book. There are 3 reference books given in the syllabus, and out of which the Juran's quality handbook, it is best reference book, I think so. Next is the syllabus for this course. The unit 1 is quality in the construction, and syllabus is as follows. There are 2 bits in this unit. First is regarding the quality and its definition and all these, and what are the contribution of quality gurus in the quality. And next bit is certain definitions, concepts are there regarding the quality, that is QC, TQC, QA, QMS and TQM. Unit number 2 is titled as TQM and Six Sigma, and syllabus is like this. TQM, its necessity, and what are the different 7 quality control tools. Then next bit is Six Sigma, its levels, its importance, and last bit is the defects and its classification in the construction. So this is regarding unit number 2. Next, unit number 3 is ISO and its quality manual. This unit comprises of various ISO 9001 principles, then the quality manual of ISO 9001, and last bit is corrective and preventive actions, and also conformity and non-conformity reports as per as the ISO is concerned. Next unit is unit number 4, management control and the certifications. In this unit, students will able to learn about this benchmarking in TQM, what is Kaizen, quality circle, then cost of the quality, and certain certifications like CONCAS, CID, CQRA. So this is regarding unit number 4. Next unit is unit number 5, that is techniques in TQM implementation and the various awards. So the syllabus, various TQM implementation techniques are there, like Kaizen, 5S, then FMEA analysis, zero defect technique, and there are certain awards are also mentioned in this unit. Some of the awards are national awards, and 3 awards are international quality standard awards are there. Next unit is unit number 6. This unit is based on another part, that not on the quality, that is on not on TQM, but this part is belongs to Management Information System, that is MIS. So little bit introduction it is given, and what is its decisions information system. Then the study is there for an construction organization associated with Buildingwars, and there is one activity for this unit mentioned in MIS. So this is regarding the syllabus of all the 6 units. Next, introduction to the TQM. We'll see what is basically the TQM, how it is evolved. Basically, total quality management is a concept created by W. Edwards Deming. It was originally introduced in the Japan after World War II, and it is to assist the Japanese in rebuilding their economy. The main focus of the TQM is its continuous quality improvement, and it is in the areas of product, services, or you can say in the employee-employee relations, consumer-business relations. Next is total quality management. Basically is a management approach that was originated in early 1950s, and then it is steadily become more popular in early 1980s. So 30 years it took to become popular method in the quality and in the management. So total quality is, you can say, it's a description of culture, attitude and organization of a company that strives to provide the customers with products and the services that satisfy their needs. Okay, that is one important thing in the TQM. And the culture which require quality in all the aspects of the company's operations, with processes being done for right time in the first time. So that is one of the principle is there regarding the total quality management. Total quality management, basically it's a method by which management and the employees can become involved in continuous improvement of the production of the goods or the services. Basically it is a combination of total quality and the management tools that are aimed at increasing the business and reducing the losses due to the wasteful practices. So the quality of a library, suppose if you want to define, and it is assessed from the perspective of different group of the people. Moreover, you can say quality of library services decides on the perception of the quality within its parent organization. This is given by the Gilbert in 1992. So you can say the practice of the quality management, and in combination with the information science, it is you can say it is the terminology used for the improvement of the continuous development and the improvement of the quality of the organization. There are certain performance indicators in this, or you can say performance evaluations are there, evaluation of the references, the sources using the prediction, and using the, you can say, recall rations. So cost benefit and cost effectiveness studies are there, user surveys are also there that are required in this quality management. So you can say the TQM, it is also having the quality assurance studies in it. This study is basically based on the you can say ISO 9001 principles, and the role of ISO in this TQM, that is quality manual, and the, you can say what are the different total quality management tools and techniques are there that are in this total quality management. So you can say defining, if you want to define the quality, It is far from easy. It is, you can say, it is just try to find why one finds that product it is not of quality. The quality refers to the grade of the services or the products, its reliability, its safety, its, you can say, consistency. It depends upon the consumer's perception. So this is what given in this total quality management subject. Thank you. In the next lecture, we are going to see, we are going to start with unit number 1, quality in the construction. So see you. Thank you.